interactivity.com. Today, we are going to dive deep into the world of GUI, that is graphical user interface programming in Python using Tkinter library. We'll walk you through the process of creating basic GUI application using Python Tkinter library. In previous video, we have already covered the basics of Tkinter library in Python. Creation of button, radio button, checkboxes. Feel free to refer to the link in the descriptions. In this video, we'll cover how to add the checkboxes using Python Tkinter library. For creating that, we'll add here one program. Just I'm right clicking on this, and here we'll add Python library. Here I will specify the name of the file as checkbox2. And we'll add this. Once we'll hit enter, you will see the edited mode available. I'm using PyCharm. So if you are using any other applications for writing this code, then probably the steps will be different. Next options I want to use or import the library for Tkinter. So here we'll use Tkinter and we'll specify as TK. So this is very much important why we are importing this as for using other attributes of Tkinter library. If we will not specify or import this library, we won't be able to use their actual attributes. After that, I will specify here root equal to tk.tk. And don't worry about it. I will explain each and everything in detail so that you learn a lot from this video. So let me write it down or create some part of the program. After that, I'll explain you each and everything. So not to worry about it. Whenever we are writing any of the attributes value or any of the options, you will get smart suggestions in PyCharm, which is very helpful for you. So here I want to add the title. That's the reason I'm adding here checkbox. That's fine. Let's understand the meaning of these three attributes. Now, the main window is created by using root or tk class. To set the title of the window, we are using here title method. So this is a method where we are specifying the title of the window. Next actions I want to add as label. So for adding the label, we will use label equal to tk dot label. And again, you will see this suggestions are available. Here we'll add class name and then we'll add text. So instead of text, we are adding into double quotes after equal to select the options. So here we'll add the label as select options and we'll add colon. Next actions I want to take as label dot pack. So equal to pad x equal to 20 comma pad y equal to 15. Now add the label widget using the label class, and for setting the label text to provide context for the checkboxes. Here we have used dot pack method to add the label to the window. Pad x and pad y are used for padding around the label for better spacing. If we will not add pad x and pad y, we will not get a proper spacing between checkboxes. Next actions I want to add as checkbox. Here we are using as variable. Here we'll use this options to add the options. Here we'll use mango as a first option to select to the user. All the options which we are selecting should be available in double quotes, and after that we have to add comma banana, and then again column double quotes grapes. So here I wanted to just target add selection of fruits, and then apple. Now this is done. Checkbox var equal to tk dot string var. And finally, we want to append the checkbox. So here we'll use checkbox var dot append, and here we'll add checkbox var. Now let me explain why we have written these options. So here if you want, we can add it here. Now the purpose of using string var class to store the state of each checkbox is to iterate to the list of options. Here we have used string var for each options. Store these string var instance in the checkbox variable list. For options in the text, we have to use checkbox. And finally, we have to define their details. So here what I will do, I will add checkbox equal to tk dot check button. And then finally we'll add root. And next options I want to add here as text. Equal to option text comma variable equal to check vars, and on value I want to add here as comma of value equal to double quotes. Now here we have added option text equal to option text, and finally here we have added of value. After that I want add here as checkbox dot pack, and finally we'll define anchor equal to tk dot w. So for creating the checkbox, we just using the checkbox button. So check button here we want to create it, and after that this is a class, and setting the checkbox text to the current option text, we are binding the checkbox to the corresponding string var using variable parameter, and use on value parameter to set the value of the string var when the checkbox is checked. We are using off value parameter to set the value of the string var when the checkbox is unchecked. And finally, pack method is used to add the checkbox to the window using the anchor parameter to align the checkboxes to left, right. And after that, for launching, we'll use root dot main loop. The importance of main loop method is already aware of it. If you don't know, I will explain you. To start the UI event loop, which keeps the application responsive. Finally, we are done. Let me save this. And here, if I will run this code, I will get some result. Now, all the issues are resolved. Let me run this flow and see the result. Now you can see after running the code, we have the title available as checkbox and the header. We have select options. So here, these are the fields which we can select it at any point of time. So this is how we can create checkboxes using Python Tkinter library, which is helping us to build a GUI based application for our any codes. So let's recap this. We have started with importing the library, and finally we have created four checkboxes for any routes, and then we have run this code and we can see the results. Now, thanks for turning in. If you found this tutorial helpful, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials. Be sure to cover other part of the video. And if you want to learn about Python, please watch my Python playlist. Happy coding.